الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعه بالإحسان إلى يوم الدين. إخوتي الفاضل، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to another episode at the North Brixton Islamic Cultural Center. Today is one of the sessions of our weekly sessions. Tonight, bi'ithnillahi ta'ala, we have a very, very interesting topic. Topic that it's important to me and yourself and all the Muslim Ummah. And of course, even non-Muslims, because all of them need to turn to Allah and seek repentance. So the topic today, bi'ithnillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the obstacles of tawbah, the obstacles of tawbah, repentance. With me, I have the Sheikh who is going to deal with this topic today, inshallah, Sheikh Abdullah Injai, on my right hand side. And inshallah, I have as well Sheikh Faisal Buadi, who will come on board later on, bi'ithnillahi ta'ala, wherever it's necessary. And I have my humble brother there, Brother Musa, the Sheikh, by the left-hand side, as you can see him. And with me, we're here to deal with this beautiful topic tonight. As usual, before I pass the mic to my beloved Ibul Sheikh, Sheikh Abdullah Injai, I will recite a few ayats from the Quran as an introduction to this topic, from chapter 25, Surah Furqan. I will start, inshallah, from verse 61 to verse 71. Thereafter, I will pass the mic to the Sheikh after narrating the nutshell meaning of this ayat to you. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم تبارك الذي جعل في السماء بروجا وجعل فيها سراجا وجعل فيها سراجا وقمرا منيرا وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكورا وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما والذين يقولون ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما والذين إذا أنفقوا لم يسرفوا ولم يقتروا وكان بين ذلك قواما والذين لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق ولا يزنون ومن يفعل ذلك يلقى أثاما يضاعف له العذاب يوم القيامة ويخلد فيه مهانا إلا من تاب وآمن وعمل عملا صالحا فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما ومن تاب وعمل صالحا فإنه يتوب إلى الله متابا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, He said, تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي جَعْلَ فِي السَّمَاءِ بُرُوجًا. Blessed be So he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who made constellations in the skies, وَجَعْلَ فِيهَا سِرَاجًا, and he placed in within that a lamp, those stars you see up there, aslam, وَقَمَرًا مُنِيرًا, and we have a moon that gives light, وَهُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ خِلْفًا, it is he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that has made the night and the day follow each other. لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَذَكَّرَ, for he who wants to be mindful, to remind himself about the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا, or they want to show gratitude to their creator. May Allah make us be amongst the grateful ones. وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ, Allah said his special servants, his own servants, the special ones. We are all the servants of Allah, but these are the special servants of Allah. He said the special servants of the most merciful. الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ, those are the ones who walk on the surface of this earth, hawna, with humility, they are humble. The true servants of Allah, when they are walking on the surface of the earth, they are humble. They walk with humility. وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ, when the ignorant confront them, the illiterate ones, the evil ones, when they confront those good ones, قَالُوا سَلَامًا, the response from the good ones will be peace. وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ, these are the ones who spend the whole night. They are in the night. لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا, they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while lying down and while standing. They remember Allah. وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا صَرِفْ عَنَّا عَذَابَ جَهَنَّمْ, don't forget this dua. They are the ones who say, oh Allah, رَبَّنَا, oh Allah, اِسْرِفْ عَنَّا عَذَابَ جَهَنَّمْ, Allah, please avert away from us. Save us from the punishments of the hellfire. Because إِنَّ عَذَابَهَا كَانَ غَرَامًا, because the punishments of the hellfire, indeed, it's a grievous one. إِنَّهَا سَاءَتْ مُسْتَقَرَّ وَمُقَامًا, it's indeed an evil place of abode. It's not good. وَمُقَامًا, a place that someone will rest. No one wants to be there if they fear Allah, if they want, no human being would love to be in Jahannam, to be honest with you. So it's a bad place of return and a place for rest. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَنْفَقُوا, these are the servants that whenever they spend, لَمْ يُسْرِفُوا, they are not extravagant. وَلَمْ يَقْتُرُوا, and they don't as well withhold everything to themselves, become stingy or greedy, no. وَكَانَ بَيْنَ ذَلِقَ قَوَانًا, they are just in balance in between. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرًا, these are the servants who do not invoke or call upon any other God besides Allah. They only call upon Allah. وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسِ, and they do not kill innocent souls. They don't go along the earth kill people, no. الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهِ, especially that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited them to do, to kill innocent souls. Don't do that. إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ, except with justice. Meaning, the one who intentionally killed, Islam say he should be killed. وَلَا يَزْنُونَ, these are the ones who do not commit adultery. وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ, Allah said, whoever does that, يَلْقَ أَثَامًا, he will receive punishment from Allah. May Allah save us from his punishments. يُضَاعَفْ لَهُ الْعَذَابُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, his punishments will be increased, doubled, the day of judgment. وَيَخْلُقْ فِيهِ مُهَانًا, Allah said he will dwell in the hellfire in agony. إِلَّا, except. Now, I want you to get this connection. That's where we're going to end. Then we'll pass it to the Sheikh for you to understand the importance of the topic today. Allah said that servants who walk on the surface of the earth, they walk with humility. Let's say one is arrogant. And those are the servants who do not spend extravagantly. Let's say the person is extravagant. And those are the servants who do not commit shirk. Let's say someone committed shirk. And those are the ones who do not kill innocent souls. Let's say the person has killed. And those are the ones who do not commit zina. And let's say the person has committed zina. And Allah said, if you did all this, then at the same time you realize it's bad. Except who turns to Allah after they've committed all these sins from today. You say, I repent to Allah. Watab, you repent. Allah said, when you repent, وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا, and they do righteous deeds. They don't just repent. They continue to do good deeds. Allah said, فَأُولَٰئِكَ, He said, those people, يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ. All the sins they've committed, all the shirk they've committed, all the zina they committed, all the lies and etc. Allah said, He's going to change it all into good for them. SubhanAllah. Allah said, يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتِ, He will change the bad to good. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا, because Allah is oft forgiven and the most merciful. وَمَنْ تَابَ, Allah said, anyone who turned to Him again and again after committing sin, you still repent. وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا, and you do good deeds. Allah said, فَإِنَّهُ يَتُوبُ إِلَى اللَّهِ مَتَابًا. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will truly turn that person to Him in repentance at all times. May Allah accept it from all of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our repentance. Without much ado, today is my beloved Sheikh's time, day. We are waiting for him to explore for us, inshallah, this session today. Falyatafaddal Sheikh, mashkura.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد وآله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. إخوة الإيمان, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. It is a great pleasure and honor for me to be here with my فضيلة الشيخ فيصل بوادي, الله يحفظه ويحفظنا جميعا. And I should not be here giving talk if my Sheikh here. But because we are in a training session, we're getting training from him, that is why we accept to give a talk here. Otherwise, I'm not entitled to give talk here. But because I get this from him, that is why I'm talking. I'm sitting down here, try to address something to you. My brothers and sisters in Islam, today I'm going to address a topic called Awaih fi Tariqi Tawbah, obstacles in the way of or preventing someone to make Tawbah. I have a lot of reading material and make some research from the Ibn Taymiyyah's book to come out with something to address this issue. Then I'm going to talk about Tawbah in the linguistic understanding and in Sharia Islamia understanding. And whether Tawbah is obligatory for everyone to make Tawbah or not, and the conditions of the Tawbah. There is a three conditions of the Tawbah if doesn't involve the right of other human being. Otherwise, it's going to be four conditions. Then come to the obstacles, like belittling sins and lot of expectation and believing that Allah is merciful, so I don't have to make a tawbah, and heedlessness of Allah's greatness and punishment, and someone depend on because they're doing a lot of deeds, so they don't have to make tawbah. So this is the things I'm going to address tonight. First, tawbah itself means in the Arabic language, Ada wa raja. Taba fi lugha min taba yatub iza ada wa raja. In the linguistic terminology, mean you return and back off from something. You was doing something, you back off and return from doing it. In the Sharia Islamia understanding, tawbah is that you return from disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why Ibn Mansur, in his great book called Lisanul Arab, Arab tongue, he defined tawbah. He said, Ta'ni ruju'u min al-dhamb. You back off and return from the sins the person has committed, then to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether tawbah is obligatory to every Muslim or everyone, tawbah is obligatory, especially for the Muslims. Every Muslims, men and women, they must make tawbah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to us, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And all of you believe in Allah, beg Allah for forgiveness, you all, and return to Him, you may be successful. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says again, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. All you who believe, make tawbah to Allah in a very sincere way. Then Allah going to forgive you your sins. Then regarding this, then tawbah is obligatory upon all of us. So we need to make tawbah. That is why the ulama, they said, the scholars, they said, tawbah is obligatory upon every single sin has been committed. Any sin anyone can commit is obligatory for that person to make tawbah. There is a conditions of tawbah. There is a three conditions of tawbah. If what the slaves done does not involve the right of other human being. For example, the first condition, al-ikhla'u anidhamb. An individual get rid of all the sins he committed and repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a very sincere way. That is the first condition. The second condition, the person regret. Ala ma salafa minhu. The person regret that the things, the sins he committed, he never go back to commit the same thing for the rest of his life or her life. The third condition, al-asmu ala an ya'uda ila misli fil mustaqbal, and have a decision and say, for the rest of my life or in the future, I'm not going to commit something like this. So this is the three conditions. And these conditions, if these three conditions has been not met, then the tawbah is not going to be accepted. But if the sin committed by the slave between him and another human fellow human being, then fourth condition arises. For example, you have to go to the person to apologize. If something you have to give him back, you take his, you give him back his right in full. Without doing that, does it matter how much the person going to read Quran and pray and do everything, Allah is not going to accept it. Then between us is the problem. Between us and Allah is much easier between us. Because sometimes I might be wrong with someone, but because I felt that I'm better than him, or look him down, or have certain thinking in my mind and say, I'm not going to go and offer my apology to him. So this is a problem. If this happens, does it matter how good the person is going to be? But Allah is not going to accept his tawbah. Then we must be aware of this. We return back the right of the others in full. Then for doing so, Allah going to accept our tawbah. Then the question here is that whether the slave, when the slave make tawbah from some of his sins, not all of it, but some of it, whether Allah going to accept his tawbah or not. This is another issue. Because someone might commit so many things and need to make tawbah in each of them. Then what going to happen? Some people, because of that, they said, oh, I cannot make tawbah because I have done so many things. So for me to make tawbah from each of us, each of them, Allah is not going to accept it. That is a mystery. The ulama, they said, the scholars, they said, if someone commits so many sins, make tawbah from some of it, Allah going to forgive him or her, but he or she need to continue to make tawbah for the other ones, to get rid of all of them. Because sometimes when we commit so many sins, become burden, you know, our heart start changing. Satan, the devil, start involving, saying to us, oh, you've done so much thing, you cannot make tawbah now, because how are you going to make tawbah for all of this? So then someone start getting lazy. So then, if someone make sins, make tawbah from some of it, Allah going to accept his tawbah. But he need to continue to make tawbah all the time until he get rid of all of it. Now, the obstacles prevent one from making tawbah. For example, disregarding one's sins. Istighfar al-dhanb. If someone regard the mistakes as a nothing or very small, that going to prevent them to make tawbah. And wahadha min alamat al-shaqa. This is a sign of being led astray for the person, saying that, oh, my sins, I just make small mistakes. I don't have to make tawbah. Then the more he continue, the more the things mounting on him or her, until at the end of the day, the ayah going to apply to him. Kalla barrana ala qulubihim ma kanu yaksibun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, those who committing sin, they continue to commit sin, until their heart come like a kettle, you know, cooking pot, the bottom of the cooking pot. When it's burned, their heart is going to be like that. Kalla barrana ala qulubihim. Or you look at the heart for those who smoke and cigarette, you see how their heart burning. Sins doing the same thing to other human beings who not smoking but committing sins. So his heart going to burn like that. So that is why For a Muslim person should not belittle his mistakes, whether he or she, saying that I don't commit so many mistakes, I don't need to have to make tawbah. Anas ibn Malik, radiallahu anhu, he said this. In his time, Anas was one of the great Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was serving the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his house as a civil servant. He lived 90 years after Prophet passed away. He lived 90 years. Anas radiallahu anhu, in his time, when things start changing, people start cheating, lying, doing other things. One day he said, إِنَّكُمْ لَتَعْمَلُونَ أَعْمَالًا أَدَّقَّ فِي أَعْيُنِكُمْ مِنَ الشَّعْرِ كُنَّا لَنَعُدُّهَا عَلَىٰ أَحْدِ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم مِنَ الْمُوبِقَةِ. He said, you indulge in bad actions which are no more significant to you than a hair. While we consider them in the time of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be great destroying sins. Anas said that because he experienced the life he lived with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahabas. And 90 years later, he experienced the changing happened to the society. I don't know if Anas lived today, what he going to say. I don't know. Sheikh Ibn Uthayyah, he said some of the things someone could do to save themselves from falling to sins. He said, معرفة قطور الذنب قطر الذنب ذنوب ما يترتب عليها أواقبها الوقيمة دررها الجسير. Sheikh Uthaymeen, Allah يرحمه, he said, these four things, a person need to know them to help him not to fall into sins. One of them, to acknowledge the danger of the sins. The second thing, what they give rise to, the sins. The third thing is that the evil consequences, the evil consequences of the sins. The fourth thing is that the extreme harm, because sins very harmful to us. So then these four things, we need to know them. Then that will help us to avoid falling to sins. Now, استذكار الذنب من قبل الأبد إنما يدل على أمور منها. I mentioned that when the slave belittle his sins and say, oh, I didn't commit a lot of sins, I don't have to make tawbah. If the slave said that means ضعف معرفته بالله العظيم الجبار المنتقم. It's a weak understanding of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, great power and lordship. If the person aware of that, whether he or she, he's not going to say that. He going to repent from his sins. Secondly, وَغَفْلَتِهِ عَنِ اللَّهِ وَعَنْ عَذَابِهِ, being headless of Allah and his punishment. If the person know how severe is Allah's punishment, they're not going to have that type of feeling. Another thing, هَذَا يَدُلُّ عَلَى مَرَضٍ فِي قَلْبِهِ وَفَسَادٍ فِيهِ. For belittling our sins is a sign of sick heart, sickness in our heart, and corruption in our heart. If the heart is sick and corrupted, that is the type of feeling the person going to have. May Allah save us from that. Ya Arhamar Rahimin. And that also, وَهَذَا يَدْعُوا أَيْضًا إِلَىٰ نِسْيَانِ الذَّنْبِ وَتَرْكِ الْإِسْتِغْفَارِ مِنْهُ. If the person belittling his own mistakes, his own sins, that means he's not going to seek forgiveness from Allah. He's not going to make istighfar from Allah to forgive him or to make tawbah, which is the repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another issue of the obstacles preventing us to make tawbah, tulul amal. Tulul amal. Like, have a lot of expectation. So, I'm going to do it tomorrow, I'm going to do it after tomorrow, and so forth. Yahya ibn Mu'in, يقول يحيى ibn Mu'az رحمه الله, of the things that prevent people from making tawbah, repentance, are so many expectations. Shaitan, the devil, always strive to discredit the believer by saying to him, take your time with regard to his to this. What is the rush? You have all the time in the world. Sometimes someone might think that I'm good enough. Oh, I'm praying, I'm reading Quran, I'm giving charity. Then they make some sins. They say, well, I'm not going to make tawbah now. Tomorrow. After tomorrow. Satan involved. Satan involved. So Yahya ibn Mu'az, he said, this is one of the things prevent one of us to make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, regarding Satan, yunadunahum alam nakum ma'akum, قالوا بلى ولكنكم فتنتم أنفسكم وتربصتم وارتبتم وقرتكم الأماني حتى جاء أمر الله وغركم بالله الغرور. In Surah Al-Hadid. For those who having expectation, delaying things day by day until the call of Allah has come. Then when that happened, it's going to be too late for someone to make tawbah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to them, you let yourself into temptation. Because temptation and tulul amal make someone not to make tawbah straight away. And you deceive by false desires. And false desires also deceive someone not to make tawbah straight away. And after that, he or she will continue and Allah's call come. When Allah's call come, wa iyyaz billah, then those sin he committed or she committed is not going to make tawbah regarding those things. Then Allah, the rest, going to believe in Allah's hand. Then my brothers and sisters in Islam, this is some of the things we must not deceive ourselves or let Satan deceive us for making tawbah. If we do so, that means our iman is very weak. Our iman is very weak. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah or Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, the believer, al-mu'min, al-mu'min, أن يكون ثابتا وأن يستخدم أوقاته في عبادة الله وعلى ما يرضي الله دون تعلق بالآمان. He said, the proper believer should stand firm, spend his time in worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all his actions, whether he or she, he try his best to do what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not to like having expectation all the time, saying that tomorrow I do this. Or Allah is Ghafur Rahim, Allah going to forgive me. So he said, the believer should not do that. Should make tawbah straight away when they commit a sin or any type of mistake. They should return to Allah, make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some of the Ba'du Salaf, they said, some of the Salaf used to say, be wary of procrastinating and always putting off things, for indeed it is something from Satan, like Tulul Amal, saying tomorrow, after tomorrow, delaying things, is from Satan. May Allah save us from Satan.
Amen.
And he said, this is from the Satan, devil, and his forces. So then Satan is the one who come to our way to make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another point is al-iqtirar bitulu hulmillah. Always saying upon the mercy of Allah, Allah's mercy is wider than anything anyone could imagine. Allah going to cover me with his mercy. So that also is something some people saying prevent them from making tawbah. But if I believe Allah's mercy is wider than anything, so I make mistake not making tawbah, then continue to do the same thing, at the end of the day, I'm not going to have anything good. For regarding that, then for us not to fool ourselves and saying Allah's mercy is wider than anything anyone could imagine. But we make tawbah, regardless, we make tawbah. Because Allah asked us to make tawbah. Abu Ali al-Rutabani, he said, one of the things many are misled by is relying solely upon the mercy of Allah. By doing so, they leave of making tawbah due to the fact that they believe Allah will always have mercy upon them. That is the thing. Because they said, we don't have to make tawbah because Allah going to forgive us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَلَمَا أَسَافُنَا إِنْتَقَمْنَا مِنْهُمْ فَأَخْرَحْنَاهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. So this is according to the people of Pharaoh as his people, Moses and Pharaoh. When Moses went to call Pharaoh, years in, year out, then they rejected his call. Then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sink them all and destroy them. So then, regarding that, Allah's punishment can come to us because rejecting what Allah offer us, Allah offer us to make tawbah and say, the bab of tawbah, the door of tawbah is open. And the person can make tawbah until the last minute of his life when he cannot take water or food or say any word. By that time, he or she cannot make tawbah anymore. But otherwise, he or she can make tawbah before that time. And tawbah going to accept until the sun comes from west. When the sun coming from west, then it's the day of judgment, then it's too late for one to make tawbah. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, oh, you are misled in believing that Allah is always merciful. Satan, the devil, was cursed forever. Satan was cursed because he believed he didn't commit a lot of sin. But he refused to make prostration for Adam when Allah gave him order. That is the only thing he refused. Then Allah curse him forever. Then if I make one mistake, or two, or three, or four, or more than that, and say to myself, I don't have to make tawbah, I'm very mistaken. Also, ماذا كان ذنب آدم عليه السلام؟ أكان ذنبا صغيرا أم كبيرا؟ آدم عليه السلام, when Allah expelled him from paradise, brought him to the earth, what was his sin? He's a minor one or big one? Allah told them, do not eat from the tree. They did. How did that happen? Satan come and deceive them and told them that, let me tell you or show you something. If you do, you're gonna have a kingdom never perish. If you eat from this tree, your kingdom never finish. For that word, for us, we love power. We love controlling. We love to be king or president or this and that. Then Adam alayhi salam eat from the tree. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expel him from Al-Jannah. That was not a big sin. So then, for someone to belittle their sins is very dangerous. It's very dangerous. وَهَذَا يُوهِي بِأَنَّ الذَّنْبُ الصَّغِيرُ قَدْ يُفْسِدُ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. That means the minor sin can destroy everything. The minor sin can destroy every single good deed. Whether we are aware of that or not, that is the danger sometimes we are facing up to. Khuturatul kalima. Khuturatul kalima wal kalam. The danger of word and talk. Sometimes we talk, we don't pay attention, we say things, we pass, and we say certain things. It's so dangerous, we don't even pay any attention. That is one of the problem as well. إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ لَيَتَكَلَّمَ بِكَلِمَةٍ مَا يَتَبَيَّنُ فِيهَا يَذَلْ بِهَا إِلَى النَّارِ أَبْعَدَ مَا بَيْنَ الْمَسْجِدِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ وَالْعِيَاسُ بِاللَّهِ. A person utters a word thoughtlessly without thinking about it being or it's been bad or good, the result of that will follow him into the fire of hell deeper than distance between the east and the west. If that is the case, then why someone should belittle their mistakes? Why someone should be delaying making tawbah? How do I guarantee myself sitting in a time, in a place, until I get up and go, I didn't make any mistake? I didn't say anything Allah displeased with it? That is why Salaf, the people of Salaf, they used to sit down in a place, they don't want to talk until they leave that place. Avoid just to say a word which is not sayable. What about us? We chat phones and other things. You talk until you drop about to death on the floor, drop on the floor. This word we say, we are responsible for it. We are responsible for it. And that is why we have to be very careful as a Muslim. What we do, we want to be good. We want to please Allah. We want to follow the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, follow his sunnah. Then we have to adopt and implement Islam to ourselves. When we do that, all the time we make istighfar, all the time, even if you sit down in a place, you was having a chat. When you, the time come for you to go, you say, Adabul Majalis, Adabul Istighfarul Majalis, Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdika, Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. You say that before you leave the place. Maybe if you make some mistake, say something with no sayable, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to forgive you. Do we do that? Sometimes we don't do that. We just carry on chatting. So, another obstacle preventing us from making tawbah, kathratul qafla. Min al-awa'i aydan, kathratul qafla. From the obstacles that prevent one from making repentance at tawbah, headlessness. So, one of the great reasons why one fall into sin due to the carelessness, being headless of Allah, and being headless of Allah's punishment. The only way can free someone from this being headless of Allah is to be reminded of Allah saying to return. Allah saying in the Quran, وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ ذِكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Therefore, remind man, in case the reminder profit them. So, if somebody headless of Allah's greatness, Allah's punishment, careless, that also is an obstacle, can make someone not to make tawbah. That is why the scholars and the du'at, they remind people all the time to make tawbah. فَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ ذِكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Remind them, because reminder is going to be beneficial to the believer. Then another obstacle, my brothers and sisters in Islam, الْيَعْفُ مِنَ التَّوْبَةِ. Thinking that Allah will not accept one's tawbah. Sometimes people commit so much things and they think that Allah won't forgive them. Wallahi, last month or month before, I went to a place, then that place was a masjid. I came out of the masjid, was coming here. Somebody come to me. Then he say, he offer his salam, I say, wa alaikum salam. And then he start crying. I said, ah, brother, what are you doing? Why are you crying? Then he said, brother, make dua for me. I said, okay, I make dua for you, no problem. But why are you crying? What happened? He said, brother, I am a bad person. I done so many things. Allah won't forgive. Wallahi, 2 months ago, broad daylight, that I nearly, my, subhanAllah, the feeling I had that day, I cannot describe. My whole body like cramp. You know, because I never experienced somebody approach me in that way, saying to me, make dua for me, crying, and say, I commit a lot of sins. What about myself? He doesn't know. I'm worse than him. He thinking that I am a good person. I'm telling you, I'm worse than him. He doesn't know. If he know how bad I am, he would have pick up from the dust and put it on my face. So, but you see, this sometimes happens. This thing sometimes happens. But we should not be think that Allah is not going to accept our tawbah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ لِعِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَطْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُذِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَتُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ ذُنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْقَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, O my slaves who transgress against themselves by committing evil deeds, and sins, despair not of the mercy of Allah, verily Allah forgive all sins. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives all sins as long the sins doesn't involve shirk. Shirk, Allah won't forgive him until the person back off from it. Between you and fellow human being, Allah cannot forgive you until you go to that person, seek, offer your apology, seek pardon from him. Otherwise, this type of sins, Allah won't forgive it to anyone. Shirk and the right of others, and the right of parents as well, Allah won't forgive it. So that's why we need to know that there is certain sin, if we commit it, we have to back down and make sure that we get rid of it before things come too late. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also say to us, وَلَا تُلْقُوا بِأَيْدِيكُمْ إِلَى التَّحْلُكَ, and do not throw yourself into destruction of your life. Because when we commit sin, we're distracting our lives. We're distracting ourselves. So sin itself, mu'awwir, is an obstacle holding us back. So that is why we must do everything to get rid of our sins. Make istighfar all the time, non-stop. Don't feel tired in saying astaghfirullah. The scholars, they said, even Sheikh Uthaymeen explained this. He said, making istighfar, the sense of it, when you make istighfar, you back off from the things you have been doing before. Because that of the sign of you making proper and sincere tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But sometimes I make a lot of istighfar, but when I go there, I'm cheating. I'm saying things, people something, I don't believe it. I deal with people in a way which is wrong, but I think because I'm clever, I have to do it. This is something we need to be aware of. Another obstacle, which is the last one, al-ikhtirar bi-kathratil amal. Some of us, we read the Quran, we pray at night, we giving charity, pray five times a day, we think that we better off. Sometimes we think we better than anybody else. You see, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to pray at night until his foot sallallahu alaihi wasallam swollen. The Sahabas learned that from him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Quran revealed to him. You tell me anyone better in Quran and praying at night and praying five times a day than Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He was making tawbah. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was making tawbah. If someone think that they have done good enough, al-a'mal saliha, indahum a'mal saliha kathira, they have lot of good deeds, they don't have to make tawbah, they very mistaken. That is a mistake. You have lot of good deeds, but make tawbah. The slave is misled into believing that due to the fact that has many righteous deeds, he will be saved regardless of whatever sin he commits. So he understands from the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, most high, inna al-hasanata yuzhibna sayyi'at. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the good deeds remove the bad deeds. So he believed that he doing good deeds, then he doesn't have to make tawba. So, but if anyone do that, they putting themselves in a very dangerous position. Doesn't matter how good you are. Doesn't matter how much, how many times you complete in Quran. Complete Quran in every 3 days, every week. But that doesn't stop you from keeping making tawbah. Because tawbah is the only thing can free you from sins. You become a free. But not making tawbah, you might do something can destroy all the good things you have done before. My brothers and sisters in Islam, therefore, he gives up making tawbah altogether. For example, the person who believes that they done good enough, or they don't have to make a tawbah, at the end of the day, they give up and altogether not making tawbah for good. So this is one of the obstacles preventing someone from making tawbah. There is so many, but because of the situation, we have just to pick up some of the obstacles and address the topic. My brothers and sisters in Islam, all I'm saying is tawbah is obligatory upon all of us. We must make tawbah all the time. The Prophet said, "Wa inni la astaghfirullah fil yawm akthar min mi'ata marra." Wa fi riwayah mi'ata marra. I seek repentance and return more than 100 times. Then if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was doing that, not in this time and age and day we living now, I think we should make thousands istighfar and tawbah a day. When you go out, you have done a lot of things, but you can cite just one thing, ruin everything. That is why we need to lower our gaze sometimes. So because there is so many things can cause them, we don't pay attention to it. We think that it's nothing. So that is why kisun maqsoof, masqoo. You have a bag, but the bag got a hole. You don't realize. Anything good you put is come out of the hole. You walking up and down. You one moment you say, where is the? Everything is gone. That is our situation today. We're doing a lot of good things, but the bag we're putting it, there's a hole in it. There is a hole in it. So we have to be aware of this. And we have to, we need to pay attention to be more conscious about our deen, about sunnah, about Quran, about making sure that we know we're not going to be here that long, whether we like it or not. If we live 100 years, it's nothing. People who live 100 years, 120 years, they gone. We here. We know we cannot live 100 years. Why are we wasting time? So that is why my brothers and sisters in Islam, this is the things I provide today just to address to you this obstacle. If I got it right, it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah's help. But if I got it wrong, it's from myself and Satan. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep me and you away from Satan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazallahu shaykhana khair al-jaza wa barakallahu fihi wa fi ahli. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward my beloved Sheikh abundantly, beautifully, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect him and his family from the punishments of this dunya and the hereafter. My dear beloved brothers and sisters, as we are almost
approaching time for Salatul Isha. We will be going, inshallah, for Salatul Isha now. And when we come back, I give you the summary of the Sheikh, and then I will go to Sheikh Faisal, bi-idhnillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll spend 20 minutes with him, and then we'll give you opportunity for 10 minutes to ask questions and answers. And then, inshallah, we will come to the end of the session. What a beautiful one. May Allah reward you, Sheikh. تقبل الله منا ومنكم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Everybody now, inshallah. Okay. Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. We thank Allah and the peace and blessings be upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear brothers and sisters in the deen, welcome again after our salah, salatul isha. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us al-jannah bi-ghayr hisab. Masha'Allah, may Allah reward our humble Sheikh Abdullah Injai for the beautiful delivery or deliverance he had done before Salah. That was a wonderful one, and we've learned from it a lot. The Sheikh talked about the Tawbah, the Ta'rif, which he said we return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala linguistically. And then he talked about the meaning of Tawbah in the deen, meaning to return from the sins you used to do and go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or on the path, the right path. And the Sheikh talked about the importance of Tawbah, whether Tawbah first of all is obligatory. He came to a conclusion that it is obligatory upon myself and all of you, every human being, to repent to Allah at all times. And the Sheikh talked about the importance of Tawbah, that when you repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the importance of that Tawbah is that Allah will forgive you and etc. until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admits you in Al-Jannah. May Allah admit all of us in Al-Jannah. Just a quick summary before I go to my dearest beloved Sheikh Dr. Faisal Buadi to come on board. The Sheikh talked about Mu'awiqat at-Tawbah, the obstacles of Tawbah. Some of them, he said, istighfar al-dhunub, to belittle the sins. When you commit a sin, you see that sin that is too small, like the one who smokes cigarette, for example, and the one who steals. When you say to the one who smokes cigarette, can you stop smoking cigarette? He said, well, I'm better than the one who wants to steal. So they compare their sins with someone saying, my own is a little one, it's better, I'm doing this. So the Sheikh mentioned an ayah from the Quran, Surah Al-Mutaffif. He said, by committing a sin, it makes the run. The run, like a pot, when you put that boiling pot underneath, how burn is, that's how the heart is. He said, it continues to commit sins until the whole heart becomes stained. And when you preach to them, it doesn't make impact anymore, because they commit these sins all the time. And the Sheikh talked about Tulul Amal, saying procrastination. Yes, I will. Oh, brother, can you pray now? Can you start doing your salah? Continue, you know, punctual your salah. Inshallah, when I'm 30 years old, I will be punctual in my deen. Oh, can you go to Hajj? Don't worry, when I'm 40 years old, that time I know I settled. Can you do this? No, when I will. And they said, at taswif wa sawfa sawfa ahlaka an-nas. Procrastination has destroyed man. You keep procrastinating for doing good things until the day the angel comes. That's what he said. And he talked about people who take advantage of the mercy of Allah. They always know, you know, our society, our community, there are people who did not even learn the Quran, but they know one ayah. When they commit sin, he said, don't worry, in Allah Ghafur Rahim. They know that one. Even if they don't read the Quran, they know Ghafur Rahim. Is that not so? All of you know it. He said, don't worry, Allah Ghafur Rahim. Allah is forgiven. But they forget that Shadidul Iqab, his punishment is severe as well. So don't take advantage of that by not doing good, the Sheikh said. And then he said, khuturatul kalima, the danger of the words that we utter without paying attention. You keep chatting, saying things, talking. He said, he gave an example until the person fell down out of chatting, phones and etc. Without paying attention, you destroy community, you destroy yourself, you destroy the heart. And then he talked about the Kathrat al-Dhunub, so much of sins. Abstain from committing sin. Remember Allah all the time. You come here to learn. Look how wonderful the sessions are. You have the Sheikh, humble Sheikh, Sheikh Faisal sitting here. It's difficult to have them. You have the other Sheikh, Sheikh Njai, my humble brother there, Sheikh Musa and others. They come to teach and learn from you. Let's take advantage. When we go out through that door, we learn. We become changed people. That's why we come here. Not to eat, not to drink, not to chat, but we come to learn. That's the priority, inshallah. I'm not saying you should not eat, inshallah, yeah? So don't get this wrong. Alhamdulillah. My humble brother said, when you come for the food, you get the lecture, you get the food. And when you come for the lecture, you get the lecture, you get the food. MashaAllah. And he talked about, he said, اغتيار كثرة العمل. Some people, they said, don't worry, I keep doing good deeds. There are so many people who build masajid, but they never pray in one. There are many. They do so many good deeds. When you talk about sadaqah, they are ready to give. They give, they give, they give. But they never, they are not even bakhshah in salah. They thought that because, yeah, keep doing good deeds is better. But this is very, very important. I don't want to go too much, inshallah. It's just to take you, you know, through so it can be, you can have the trend to connect you as well with Sheikh Faisal's contribution. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it. But before I go to the Sheikh, one of the most dangerous things the Sheikh talked about the tawbah, when it is between you and your fellow human being. If your brother or sister does not forgive you, Allah will not forgive you. Whether you pray, you stand in the night until morning, you read the Quran many times, and you keep offending people, they don't forgive you. Your mom does not forgive you. Your dad doesn't forgive you. Your brothers and sisters you've wronged, they don't forgive you. Allah will never forgive you. Don't forget about this. So whatever rights you have for that person, the Sheikh said, return it back to them in full. Return it back in. Beautiful. May Allah accept it. فَلْيَتَفَدَّلْ شَيْخِ مَشْكُورِ.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Well, you have our may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our salat first of all, and those who are going to the grave beyond, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive for them. And those who are still alive, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us nifas as Muslims and may us Muslims. Well, he mentioned two things here. One is seeking forgiveness, istighfar, and the next one is at-tawbah, isn't it? So, are there any difference between forgiveness, seeking forgiveness, and making tawbah, seeking repentance? Are they different? Oh, they are all the same.
Yes.
There's a difference.
Yes.
Oh, this is the first time I have ever heard that.
Yes.
Who can tell me the difference?
What's the difference?
What's the difference?
Yeah, the difference is that making tawbah is you are trying to subdue yourself to what you have done wrong. And asking for forgiveness is just a general mistake you do, which you don't understand, and it's not directly towards somebody.
Someone talking at the back.
Good. Yes, anybody else? Who has omission or commission to what he had said? You have omission or commission? Okay, then go ahead. Now,
so you are asking for forgiveness, you are asking Allah to forgive you for the mistakes you've done. And when you repent, you're asking Allah that you're repenting from everything you've done and you're not coming back to it.
Yes.
You're repenting finally that I've been doing this sort of things, now I'm repenting. I'm a killer, I'm repenting, I don't think I'll kill anymore.
Oh, okay.
So that's the meaning of repentance.
All right. When our clothes become very dirty, what do we do? You wash it with what?
Yes.
With what? With soap. Okay. And then after that, what do you put on it?
Iron.
You put perfume on it, isn't it? Good. So, one of them is soap, and the next one is perfume. So, which one of them is soap? The Tawbah or the Istighfar? Yes.
Tawbah.
Tawbah.
Is the soap.
Is the soap?
Yes.
Okay. Anybody else?
Istighfar is the soap.
That is very pretty. I love that one. Yeah, that is very pretty. I love it. Hey, you see, it's very nice. Good. Istighfar, seeking forgiveness, that is the soap. You want to wash the sins that you have committed, isn't it? And the Tawbah is repentance. And I've told you that repentance has how many syllables you have it then? Two, isn't it? Re and pent. What's the meaning of re?
That's you're not returning.
Huh?
You're not returning.
Re means returning, isn't it? And pent is what? What's the meaning of pent?
You talk what you have done.
Pent is the
penthouse, what's a penthouse? Have you ever seen a penthouse before? Huh? What is that?
Small house.
Small house? Where do you find it?
At the back.
On the top of the mountain. Very pretty. I love that one. So, that is the itzel. That is the perfume. After you have sought forgiveness, then here you come to put perfume on it. So go to Quran chapter 4, verse 17 to 18. Sorry, we don't have much time, so.
Yeah, chapter 4, Surah Nisa, verse 17 to 18. And hear what Allah says. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إنما التوبة على الله للذين يعملون السوء بجهالة ثم يتوبون من قريب فأولئك يتوب الله عليهم وكان الله عليما حكيما وليست التوبة للذين يعملون السيئات حتى إذا حضر أحدهم الموت قال إني تبت الآن ولا الذين وليست التوبة للذين يعملون السيئات حتى إذا حضر أحدهم الموت قال إني تبت الآن ولا الذين يموتون وهم كفار أولئك أعتدنا لهم عذابا أليما. Allah said, He said, إنما التوبة, He said, indeed, the repentance, accepted tawbah, in other words, accepted repentance. Alallah, that which Allah accepts, the tawbah that Allah accepts. لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السُّوءَ. It is for those when they commit evil, when they commit sin. Immediately, when they do that, bijahala, out of ignorance, ثم يتوبون من قريب. They turn to Allah in repentance immediately. They did that out of ignorance, but when they knew, they repent straight away. SubhanAllah. Which means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it obligatory on him as well to accept their tawbah. As long as they turn to Allah immediately after ignorance, then they are aware that I have done wrong, like today you've heard, and then you repent to him, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will repent, will accept that repentance, inshallah. فَأُولَٰئِ Allah said, those people, يَتُوبُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِمْ He said, it is upon me to accept their repentance. Why? وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلِيمًا Because Allah is the knower of everything. Hakim is the most wise. وَلَيْسَتِ التَّوْبَةِ But this tawbah will not come to an effect, or their tawbah will not be accepted. Who? لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السَّيِّئَاتِ For those who commit evil, حَتَّى إِذَا حَدَرَ أَحَدَهُمُ الْمَوْتِ When they commit evil, they keep saying, I will. Huh? Procrastination. I will repent. I will. I will. Until when Malak al-Maut appears. When Malak al-Maut comes, when death comes to them, قال, then the person will say, إِنِّي تُمْتُ الْآنِ Oh God, I have repented now, please. Allah said, no, I'm not going to accept it at that time. وَلَلَّذِينَ يَمُوتُونَ وَهُمْ كُفَّارٌ Not for those as well who die as unbelievers. So there are two people yet. Those who are not unbelievers, they are Muslims, but they don't seek forgiveness. They don't do tawbah until when death comes. And those who are kuffar, they die as disbelievers. Allah said he will not accept it. Ulaik, he said, those ones, all those categories, a'tadna lahum, I have prepared for them, azaban, aleem, painful punishment, yawm al-qiyam. May Allah save us from them. Let's go to Surah 66, Ayah 8. See what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says there. Yeah, 66. Surah Tahrim. Ayah 8, huh? Okay.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا توبوا إلى الله توبة نصوحا عسى ربكم أن يكفر عنكم سيئاتكم ويدخلكم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار يوم لا يخزي الله النبي والذين آمنوا معه نورهم يسعى بين أيديهم وبأيمانهم يقولون ربنا أتمم لنا نورنا واغفر لنا إنك على كل شيء قدير
آمين يا رب Allah said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا He called on you, the believers, all you who believe. تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ All of you right now, turn to Allah in repentance. Seek forgiveness. Repent. The Shaykh asked me, but in what way? Allah has answered to that question. He said, تَوْبَةً نَصُوحَ Sincere repentance. It's not lip services. Saying, I repent, and he did not turn to him in the reality. But it comes from the heart. Tawbat al-Nasuha, sincere repentance. By doing so, Asa Rabbukum, your Lord, أن يكفر عنكم سيئاتكم, will expiate your sins, will wash your sins off you. Not only that, ويدخلكم, he will admit you. جنات تجري, In paradise, underneath that Jannah, min tahtiha, underneath al-anah with him. Nuruhu, he said the believers, when they come to the day of judgment from their graves, they have special lights. Their lights, yas'a bayna aydihim. Their rights will go, will move ahead of them, beyond, you know, before them. Subhanallah. They will have their lights before them. They have their lights. And also of the aymanihim, and they will have it as well on their right hand side, penetrating. When they see their lights, they will say, Yaqulun, they will say, Rabbana, O Allah, Atmim lana nurana. O Allah, accomplish, fulfill our light. Not only that, Faghfir lana, forgive us. Why? Because innaka ala kulli shayin qadir. You have the power to do everything when and how you want it. May Allah forgive our sins.
Amen. SubhanAllah. Well, I think you have heard what I have said here. Now, you have to make tawbah. Tawbah does not mean that you have to sit only one place and that is it. No. It doesn't mean that. You have to make sure that you make a lot of zikr. When you make a lot of zikr, it helps you. You remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know that every day, the earth upon which you are going up and down, does it love me and you? Huh?
This earth.
Does the earth love me and you? Yes? Mm. What about the sky? The sky also loves me and you?
That's why it doesn't come down on you.
Good. You see, every day and all the time, some parts of the earth ask another part. هَلْ مَرَّ عَلَيْكَ مَنْ يَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى And you? Did anyone pass, walk on you today, who was making zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If the other one said yes, he becomes very jealous. The one that people pass by, but they did not what? Make zikr, he becomes very jealous about the one, the part where you have other people passing by and making zikr. Okay. It means it is so important so that Yawm al-Qiyamah, it will bear witness for you. It will bear witness for you, Yawm al-Qiyamah. And hence, you should all the time try to make zikr when you are walking, when you are sitting, you are moving, anyhow, make a lot of zikr. Make a lot of zikr. Don't sit in one place and that is it. No. Make zikr all the time so they bear witness for you, inshallah. Well, you will not go to other aspects of all this, what is called the tawbah, in terms of the three aspects of it and so forth. But you will leave it today, inshallah ta'ala, and you pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each and every one of you, inshallah. Salaam alaikum.
Mashallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward my humble sheikh. You can see the diversity and beauty of the deen, how both of them approached the audience today. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts this in our mizan. My dear respectable brothers and sisters, as I've always said, bushra lakum, good news for you. The good news is to always reassure you that majtama'a qawmun fi baytin min buyutillah. Whenever people gathered, as we have gathered here in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the angels, they surround us right now. We're being surrounded by the angels. That's one. And also, the sakina, the tranquility of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been descending upon us since when we start up to the time we're going to finish. And then the third one, what does the angel do? The angels, they seek forgiveness for you. You've been sitting here now, they have been seeking forgiveness for you. The same istighfar we are talking about, the same tawbah, they are asking Allah to accept your tawbah. They are praying for you to be forgiven. Huh? They are praying for you to be forgiven. And the fourth one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well, He mentions you, each and every one of you, your name. Remember, those when they call Maryam, what do they call them? Mar, is it? Those who they call Abdullah, how do they call them? Abdu. And those who they call Muhammad, how do they call you? Mo. Imagine. Yeah, that's what it do. In Islam, you should be called by your name. Imagine they call you Mo. And then Allah said, what's the name of thy servant? They call him Mo. After they've called you Muhammad. So however, the hadith, the Rasulullah s.a.w. said, Allah will mention each and every one of you, your names, to the angels. All the angels. He said, look at my servants. They are remembering me. They are glorifying me. They are seeking forgiveness. And also, just for me to finish the hadith for you. Also, what did they do? The angels, when they finish, they go to Allah. He said, Allah, all the servants are there, mashallah. They are asking you for Al-Jannah.
And Allah will say to them, had they set eyes on my Jannah, what do you think they would have done? Said Allah, they would have worshipped you more than they do. And Allah will say, I have granted forgiven all of them. Oh, may Allah forgive all of us. And then they will say, Allah, they seek refuge, your protection from the hellfire. And Allah will say, had they set eyes on my Jahannam, what would they have done? He said, Allah, they will never, ever, ever go Gosa. Never will they talk about their brothers and sisters. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, because of that, I have prevented them, prohibited their flesh from Jahannam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it for us. And not only that, another good news. I don't mean those who come today to the session. Yeah? Another good one. Listen, don't feel guilty. Yeah? They'll say, Allah, yeah, you're forgiving them. We're not questioning you. But amongst those sisters, or amongst those brothers, there is one sister or one man. That one, he always does chakara. Problem. Even Salah is a problem. But today, she decided to go and sit with them. Allah will say, because she sat with them, because he sat with them, I have forgiven her or him until the end.
Amen.
Good news, isn't it?
Yes.
So this is the gathering. This is where we need to spend our time. This is where we need to spend our moments. You come with your heart, Allah will forgive you. It reminds me, less than 1 minute, it reminds me, the man who came to the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when they said, the man sees his, I call it, how they call this one?
Eyebrow,
whatever, is gone down. The man is so old. Old man, huh? He had his walking stick coming to the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He said, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He did not want, you know, some people, when they commit sin, they come to ask you questions. That's what they do to the sheikhs. They do to us, yeah? They don't mention them. They said, Sheikh Yusuf, Sheikh Buhadi, or Sheikh Nijaya, Sheikh Musa. What about if so and so person does this? It's good. It's part of the sunnah. You don't need to expose yourself. Don't need to say, I did this. No, say, what about so-and-so person did this? That's what the man, the sahabi, did to the Rasul. He said, Ya Rasulallah. He said, Ara'ait, do you see that man who has committed all the type of sins you can imagine in the world? He said, not even like a chicky. He did not leave a chicky. A flower. He said, nothing. He left nothing. Yeah? Except he has done it. He said, do you think God will forgive that person? Yeah. And then the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, mashallah, look at the Rasul. He did not ask him, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he did not ask him that, does the man pray? Or the man ask, have Islam? He asked him directly, he said, Hal aslamt? Are you a Muslim? Allahu Akbar. In the hadith, he said, are you a Muslim? He said, yes. Do you testify that there is no God except Allah? You do good deeds? He said, yes. He said, Allah will forgive you. He said, huh? He said, really? Say, yeah. He said, yeah, Rasulullah. Fajarati wa adarati. Now, he did not say the man's biggest sins. He said, my biggest sins are all the evil I've committed, ya Rasulullah. The Rasul said, Fajarati wa adarati. He said, all those dangerous ones, everything, Allah will change it to good. The man did not even look at the Rasul again. He was going to say, Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Until he disappeared. So that's what we say today. Ghadaratina wa fajaratina. Nas'aluka ya Allah. أن تغفر لنا ذنوبنا جميعا اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبا جميعا اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا جميعا اللهم لا تجعل لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا عيبا إلا سترته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا مريدا إلا شفيته ولا ضالا منا إلا هديته نسألك أن ترفع مكتك وغضبك عنا ولا تؤاخذنا بما فعلنا ولا تؤاخذنا بما فعل سفه منا ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات يقوم الحساب. نسألك يا الله أن تطهر قلوبنا من الفسوق والعصيان ومن الحسد والبغضاء ومن الكفر والكبرياء ومن الشرك والشك والنفاق يا الله. اللهم حبب فيما بيننا. اللهم حببنا يا الله. اللهم حببنا يا الله. اللهم ادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وآخر دعوانا
أن الحمد لله رب العالمين سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك ونشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We want to say thank you Sheikh Musa. Sorry we did not hear from our Sheikh today, but in fact the topic we're going to give Sheikh Musa will tell you inshallah is about polygamy.